dr.zack. The name you always hated and complained about is now decimal Z. And from now on, this is my logo. What you gonna say about it, son?
Decimal Z. Hi, Flat Earthers, this is Zach. Well, this is something that I discussed with my friend Sander and I wanted to share it with you. So if you like to pay attention to the smallest things like I do, then this video is for you. They say that gravity pulls everything to the center of the Earth, but then they shoot themselves in the foot when they say that the Earth is not a perfect sphere.
So it's not actually a sphere, it's oblate. And officially, it's an oblate spheroid.
And today, I'm going to show you what this means. But first, let's talk about gravity. So, if we assume that gravity really exists, a lot of problems with the heliocentric model would be solved, such as...
What keeps us stuck to the Earth? Why do we keep spinning around and around? Why doesn't the vacuum of space suck the atmosphere?
So gravity is the answer of almost every hard question that could come to your mind. But the funny thing is, if you ask about gravity itself, you will find out that it's still an unproven theory. But guess what? They teach it in school as a fact. So when we grow up and we hear somebody saying that gravity doesn't exist, we just laugh and we think that the guy is crazy. But hold on a second. If they say it's just a theory, then why are we still taking it as a fact? Check out this website, National Center for Science Education. Gravity is only a theory. And if you go down here, the universal theory of gravity is often taught in school as a fact, when in fact it is not even a good theory. And if we go to this government's website, we find out pretty much the same thing. What is gravity? And the answer is...
We don't really know. We can define what it is as a field of influence because we know how it operates in the universe.
And God only knows how they knew that.
And some scientists think that it is made up of particles called gravitons which travel at the speed of light. However, if we are to be honest, we do not know what gravity is in any fundamental way. We only know how it behaves.
So they are technically saying that gravity is a law. But only a law inside the theory of relativity. And today I want to show you guys that if gravity exists and the Earth is really not a perfect sphere, then everything in most of the places on Earth would not fall down on a perpendicular way. And that means that you would not be walking like this in some places, but you would be walking like this. Well, maybe like this. Anyway, if the Earth is a perfect sphere, then they will have no problem. Because everything will be pulled down to the center of the ball, and everything will look perpendicular on the surface. And how do we know these lines are perpendicular? All you have to do is draw a line. You can imagine it as a laser. Draw it from this point where this line and the circle intersect and make sure it is perpendicular on this line. This new line will never hit the circle anywhere. And of course, this line right here will go directly to the center of the Earth. But if you draw a perpendicular line right here, for example, it will not go to the center. It will only go to the center if it passes through this specific point. And of course, you can do the same thing from all points on the surface of the circle. But if the Earth is not a perfect sphere, and it's an oblate spheroid, as they say, then what would happen? Let's see. I'm gonna make the Earth look like an egg so you guys can see the difference, and then we will see it in real scale. So if the Earth is like this, then the lines over here cannot be perpendicular to the surface because the Earth is no longer a perfect sphere. So if we do the same thing like we did before and draw the laser from the same points, it will eventually go underground. And what does that mean? If you were this line, you would be walking in a tilted way like the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Alright? And your laser will go underground. But does that happen anywhere on Earth? Okay, let me explain this a little bit more because it's kind of confusing. When you are on a ramp, you feel it. And the reason why you feel it is because you are no longer perpendicular to the ground. Mainstream science claims that gravity is what makes you feel that you are perpendicular to the ground. If you were on a ramp and tried to measure this angle, it would not be 90 degrees. And that's obvious because you already feel it. But if the Earth was an oval, and if you were on this specific area, you would be tilted and not perpendicular. And if you measured your angle, it would not be 90 degrees. And the difference is, you should not feel that you are tilted, because walking tilted would be a normal thing, and walking perpendicular would be harder. But you and I know that this is unnatural and it will never happen. Well, of course some globers will say that the Earth is not really like that, but this was just to explain the point. Now, we're gonna see it in real scale. Here is the World Geodetic System with two different radiuses, and I also draw a perfect sphere with a radius of 3959 miles, so you can see the difference between them, and it's really small. But in geometry, any difference makes a difference. So in order to see the difference between these two circles, I'm gonna put them above each other. Keep in mind that right now, both circles have the same center. Now I'm gonna zoom in to see the difference. As you can see, the difference is really small. Now this line right here comes from the center of both circles. And if we draw a 90 degree line on the perfect sphere, which is the blue one, we will notice that it will never touch the circle anywhere else. And that proves that there is nothing flat on a perfect circle or a sphere. This is just a message to the people who think that seeing something that is a few miles away is normal on a spherical object. It's not. Now I'm gonna move this 90 degree line to the oblate spheroid, and we will see that the line is going underground. And this happens just a few miles away from the star's point. You capture the difference? Well, this may be hard for the globe believers to demonstrate, but if we focus on this line only, then you should be able to measure this angle, and it cannot be 90 degrees. It should be around 89 or 88. It depends on where you are on Earth. So please, globe believers, if you believe that the Earth is not a perfect sphere, can you do an experiment that shows that things do not fall down perpendicularly to the Earth in many places on Earth? If you want to do it, please do it on water, okay? Do something, prove your science. Please.
If you like this video, then I'll be before you. Subscribe. Decimal Z.